the Royal Derby, one of Britain's newest and largest hospitals, treating a million patients a year.
You're in hospital.
Every day here, lives begin and lives are saved.
It's adrenaline, please.
The stakes are high. The decisions we make the difference whether a patient lives or dies.
Right, who am I going into battle with now?
Behind every life-changing moment...
Calm down. Oi!
We'll go and make the toast.
...is an extraordinary team of over 8,000 staff.
We're living the dream, you and me here, aren't we, Sam Top?
Each one dependent on the next.
We are like a little work family.
Take one member out of that family and it doesn't function.
Three, two, one, go.
Continue this search for a missing patient.
You look
Thank
after
you
him.
So much.
Pleasure.
From the surgeons to the sweepers.
Just behave yourself, that's all.
I just need to get this right.
It's quite intense, but it's what we do.
As a new day begins...
Come on in.
Staff from 150 different professions across 105 departments are getting ready for the day ahead. In the chemotherapy suite, Caroline treats up to 16 cancer patients on every shift.
This environment is unique. It's the only place where you can get to know your patients really well. You really do get to chat and have the crack with them.
When they're up, walking, ready for home, that is it for me. I fill up. When, you know, they're hugging you and thanking you, there's no better reward, really. And that's when you go home, you think, yes, we've done well there.
Everybody in those hospital beds is somebody else's mother, grandmother, sister, whatever. And you can look at an x-ray and see broken bones or degenerate hips, but you can't fail to appreciate the fact that that is someone's relative.
You've just got to be as tolerant. If you've been here an hour into the shift or 11 hours into the shift, you've still got to show the same amount of care and empathy to a patient.
You're really struggling pain-wise.
I'm struggling.
You are, aren't you? It's like you're having electric shocks.
I think it's so important to try and put yourself in the patient's shoes.
Shall we take this arm out?
Yeah, just
the side. Are you decent? Are you covered up?
Yes, I'm covered up. We'll try and make a bit more of an effort, even if it's just sitting holding the hands for 10 minutes, just to reassure them and let them know what's going on.
You want one that side?
We've got a very privileged role. There's not many jobs where you do get such close bonds with the family. You know, we can give our baby their first bottle. We can see them take their first breath. So we're very lucky.
Hand in. Put your finger where mine is. Mm-hmm. Go right the way down. Go nearer to me.
So being a surgeon involves having huge responsibility because you can affect the ultimate change in somebody's life.
It's a bit like wrestling a goldfish. Mm.
You can cure them of pain, you can take away cancer, you can, you know, the power you have to cause a change is immense.
There'll always be a steady stream of patients coming here at the Royal Derby who are often at their weakest and most vulnerable. Sometimes we can fix them and sometimes we can't. But the key thing is we'll never stop trying.
We're like the Charlie's Angels, aren't we?
The Avenging Angels, don't you?
Here we are, girls. Don't fight over him.
What I've learned from working here is take the good with the bad, but never take anything for granted. Never, ever, ever.
I've seen in my travels around the hospital so many people that genuinely feel for people that are ill. I don't think it matters whether you're being paid a fantastic amount or whether you're, like me, a volunteer that's doing it for nothing. You're contributing to these people's welfare. Long may it last.